What do you want to be when you grow up? We ask kids this question starting at a very young age. And like most children, I thought there were only four professions in the world: a doctor, a fireman, an astronaut, or a teacher. And as the son of a physician and a registered nurse, I always thought I was destined to become a doctor. Every class I took in high school was geared towards medicine in some way. When I took aptitude tests to determine which career was right for me, I always chose answers that I knew would point towards the medical field. But as an undergraduate at Weber State University, I found that most of the pre-med students were majoring in zoology. But I had no desire to end up cleaning a zebra enclosure for the rest of my life. So I chose to major in microbiology, the only class that had interested me to that point. As part of an undergraduate research project, my professor had me observe fecal samples under a microscope from South American villagers, looking for a parasitic infection. I became fascinated with the thought of samples from patients that were thousands of miles away from me. I felt like I was impacting their lives, and I knew that they were impacting mine, because I could smell it in their poop. My interest in research led me to take the only class about viruses at Weber State University. I was fascinated by the ability of these tiny organisms to cause so many different diseases and the strategies used by each of them. I knew that I wanted to work somewhere where I could learn more about viruses. During my senior year, I applied for a job at Utah State University working for the Institute for Antiviral Research. My professor told me that I would be able to work for them and possibly attend graduate school as well. A week before graduation, I was offered the job. While I may have been interested in research at Weber State University, at Utah State University, it's become a part of my life. During the past 10 years, I've worked as a research technician and also completed a master's degree. I've had an opportunity to work about many of the viruses that you've probably heard about in the news. In 2009, as the swine flu pandemic was headline news on every channel, and as people were worried about getting infected at Walmart, I was busy growing the virus in a lab and testing the virus for sensitivity to new drugs. In 2014, as Ebola virus was being publicized as the largest outbreak ever of Ebola, I was busy shipping compounds to a collaborator in Texas to identify new treatments for this deadly virus. And as the world learns more about the dangers of the Zika virus, we have been developing new assays to test compounds for this emerging infection. We are working on ways to understand how Zika virus is transmitted and how it is able to cause disease. And while I've been involved in research on many of these famous diseases that you've heard of, we've also been working on others that you may not be familiar with. I want to tell you what I'm researching as part of my PhD studies right now. In 2014, enterovirus 68 was identified as the cause of a respiratory disease that likely infected millions of Americans. This respiratory virus appeared similar to a flu infection, but doctors noticed more serious signs of disease. Some of the young children infected with this virus had paralysis of their arms, and some have not been able to use their arms since being infected. The 2014 outbreak had 1,000 confirmed cases across 46 states, with a dozen cases right here in Utah. This respiratory virus is similar to enterovirus 71, which is a cause of hand, foot, and mouth disease. Both of these viruses are related to poliovirus, a disease which killed or paralyzed 500,000 people a year at its peak. These enteroviruses are able to infect the nervous system of young children and cause disease and damage that lasts even after the virus is gone from the body. My research has been studying these viruses to determine how they infect people, what makes them target the nervous system, and testing new compounds to treat the spread of these diseases. Whereas a physician, I may have only encountered one or two of these diseases in my career. As a researcher, I've been a part of all of them. Through my research, I have been able to gain insights into the careers of the medical careers of both of my parents. I've been able to also share my research about viruses with them. My admiration for my parents and their career led me on a path to research. They have helped shape the person and the researcher that I have become. And while my parents have had a strong influence on my career, I realize that I'm affecting those around me as well. I was reminded of this by the fact that the other day, while explaining to our neighbor that our daughter had the flu, my 8-year-old son corrected me and said, "No, she doesn't have the flu, she has influenza." While I may have started off in research as a way to prepare myself for medical school, at a certain point, research stopped being a means to an end. As I understood the impact that I could have on the world and on those around me, research became my passion and my life. And while we may not all grow up to be doctors, we can all grow up to impact the world in our own way. Thank you.